Please remain standing. Please remain standing as Father Tom Baptist, the president of Crespi, begins the ceremony with the opening prayer.
I'd like to just begin by welcoming everyone here today, including my high school history teacher, Mr. Bill Butler, who is in the audience. Let us pray. Creator God, as we gather to celebrate the achievements of our graduating selves, we pause to give you glory. We thank you for your faithfulness, your love and mercy, and for your many blessings. We thank you for the gift of our lives and the opportunities you present to us each day to use those gifts in service of the kingdom. The faculty, staff, and administrators of Crespi Carmelite High School, thank you for the opportunities given us to work with these young men over the past 4 years. May that work bear fruit in their lives and achievements, and in the service these selves will give in the years ahead. We pray for our graduates' families and for all self families that you will support and guide them. May they continue to acknowledge your presence in their lives. Our thoughts and prayers this day are most especially with our graduates. We pray that your wisdom may light the path ahead for them. May each self experience your love. May they have the courage of our spiritual father, Elijah the prophet, as they seek to bring about justice. May they have the heart of Mary, our spiritual mother, and never be blind to the needs of the poor and the homeless. May their considerable intellectual, artistic, and athletic talents be put to the service of humanity. We thank you, Lord God, for all you have given us, and pray that we will continue to use our gifts to build your kingdom here on earth. We pray in Jesus' name, amen. Our Lady of Mount Carmel,
pray for us. Please remain standing as the salutatorian Anthony Martinez leads us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Thank you. You now may be seated. Of course, we're excited here to celebrate the accomplishment of the class of 2014, but we're also honored to have with us the very first principal of Crespi Carmelite High School, Father Gus Carter. Let us thank him for his part in establishing the traditions that we continue today. Each year, a graduation committee reviews the essay submissions of students who hope to deliver the commencement speech. This year, the committee has chosen to bestow the honor of delivering the commencement speech to Quinn Muldoon.
We will be walking out of this gym, diploma in hand, as proud of Crespi. As we sit here in our final minutes as high school students, overcome by excitement and anticipation, we need to take a deep breath. We are here. This is the last time we will enter the Crespi campus as students. And in minutes, we will be leaving campus for the first time as a crowd of Crespi graduates. In these last 4 years, we've had a lot to learn, and definitely went beyond the curriculum. We learned about what it means to be a brother, what it means to be a man, and what it means to be a self. As brothers, we formed amazing bonds. Looking around at all my brothers sitting up here alongside me, I see the wonderful people I've been privileged to know for the last 4 years, the lifelong relationships that we've made, and all the wonderful, hilarious experiences we've had. These years were a blur, and in hindsight, went by in the blink of an eye. We've had so many memorable experiences here in our times that, if I were to name them all, I'd well overstay my welcome to speak. However, I'd be remiss not to take a moment to reminisce. Freshman year, I remember walking into school for orientation and being nearly terrified by the massive seniors and the thought of entering this new world of Crespi. We were so young and innocent, and we yet to realize how amazing our Crespi experience would be. Nor did we understand that Crespi was blessed with such a funny, talented, smart, and good-looking class. As the year progressed, we settled in and started making friends. Crespi felt like home. We got to know our teachers and understand the reality of the Crespi experience. I mean, who'll ever forget Mr. Sweeney's freestyles, or his fantastic story about a tiger and 40 vocab words? Or when we stood in the stands at the Notre Dame football field and witnessed the miracle in the valley. Then, sophomore year. This was the year we got to keep it real with Mr. Lewis and his perfectly cheesy jokes. We were also exposed to the legend that is Mr. Medea for the first time. And we got to see the creative side of religion and the pertinence of Plato in one's education in sophomore religion class. We got to experience the advent of Mr. Jean Salute, his sweet melodic voice, and his amazingly energetic personality. And we were all cheering for the basketball team as they made a run deep into the playoffs. By the end of the year, we all felt the ties of brotherhood. And then, junior year, we continued the path of becoming men. Junior year was the dawn of SAT classes and the stresses of trying to find a college. Junior year was also the dawn of the band. It was the first time all of the Crespi men showed up to sport games clothed in Hawaiian shirts, ready to make a name as the best student section in the league. We got the brilliant opportunity to cheer on our lacrosse team as they won Crespi's first ever league title in lacrosse. We lost our beloved Miss O'Connor that year, but we saw the return of Coach Thomas. Another year quickly passed, and we watched as the seniors graduated, leaving us with the responsibility and privilege of taking over the school. Then, senior year, we took over the campus. We were the leaders, and we had the role of setting the example for the rest of the school. We were also quick to affirm the stories about Mr. Gillis's copious notes and Mr. King's expansive lexicon. We were blessed to have Ms. Rezzo as a teacher and got to experience a wonderful myriad of scented hand sanitizers. We were quick to take advantage of campus ministry as a place to study, do work, and watch Sports Center. And we were always visiting with Mrs. Long and Mr. K in their offices. The time quickly came when we were receiving acceptances and some rejections from colleges. And if it weren't for Mrs. Barkins, senioritis might have run rampant. This year has been fantastic, and I would not have wanted to spend it with anyone other than the UCU today. We've had an amazing time here, and a multitude of splendiferous experiences throughout our freshman careers. And as Sean Combs once said, we can't change the world unless we change ourselves. Over the last 4 years, I've seen us all change greatly, and as Celts, we've changed our Crespi family. And looking at all these faces of my fellow graduates, I don't just see the past and present, I also see the future. Now, the time has come that we go forward to change the rest of the world, and I can see every single one of us doing it. This year, the whole nation got to see what self-pride was, as we watched London Toronto's playing March Madness. I can see Sal changing forever what it means to be passionate. I can see Eric changing the standard for movie editors when he received his first Oscar. I can see Shay and Johnny changing the face of entrepreneurship. and I can see Alex changing history by winning the World Cup for America. Every single one of us going forward has endless potential and can, without a doubt, be the change they wish to see in the world. As Christopher George Latour Wallace said, make sure your heart is in it and live the phrase, the sky is the limit. None of this could have been possible without the hard work and tireless dedication of our fantastic Crespi teachers, administrators, and community. The thanks I'm about to give don't come close to expressing the amount of gratitude we all feel. Mrs. Long, you have supported me as a leader. You are truly a mother to all the men at this school, and you are always saving the day and making sure that our time at Crespi is enjoyable, all the while showing love and compassion to 525 Crespi kids. Teachers, thank you for giving us not only the facts, but also the tools to use them. Not only giving us knowledge, but wisdom as well. Thank you for always somehow managing to put up with us. We all know that's no easy task. You were all here to share a laugh with us or let us know when we went too far, and this we truly appreciate. Administration, thank you for taking care of us outside the classroom. You always had the best interest of not only the school, but also the students in mind while you conducted your business. Parents, we share a tremendous thanks to you for giving us the opportunity to come to school here and not only get a great education and get into college, but also expand our families by forming bonds with our Crespi brothers. Lastly, to my fellow graduates, my brothers, I thank you for the greatest 4 years of my life. You guys have carried me through the tough times and made the good times even better. You've taught me so much about myself and the world around me, and I hope I was able to do the same for you. Yes, we are going to be graduates, but we will always be Crespi men. Class of 2014, take a deep breath and let it all soak in. You will never go to class of Crespi again. You'll never have to stand in the lunch lines or get written up for being out of dress code. Whether this makes you ecstatic or morose, remember, this is not the end. It's simply a new beginning. We have finished with high school. Now it's time to live out what we learned here. Gentlemen, we made it. We are here together, and we are the class of 2014. Thank you.
Before the presentation of diplomas, we have a few special awards and acknowledgments to make. The following awards were voted on by the faculty and staff of Crespi. And the first one is the Most Outstanding Student Award. This award is given to the student who has distinguished himself in all aspects of life at Crespi, for service to his fellow classmates and the Crespi community at large, as well as his dedication to the values we believe in. The winner of the Most Outstanding Student Award is Hayden Singh. Tierney Cahill Award is given to the senior whose service and dedication to others has set him apart over the past 4 years. For this year, the winner of the Father Tierney Cahill Award is Joseph Reyes. This next award is given to the senior who has shown spirit and dedication to Crespi Carmelite High School. The Crespi Carmelite Spirit Award goes to Shay Von Hetzenberg.
The Paul Muff Commitment Award is an award given to a senior who represents Paul Muff's overall commitment to Crespi athletics, social life, religious activities, and academics. This year's winner is Gino Gasparo. The Peg O'Connor Commitment Award is an award given to a senior who represents Peg O'Connor's dedication, hard work, overall care for others, and ability to inspire those around him. This year's winner is Joseph Yingerts. Given to a senior who best exemplifies the Crespi Man statement of productive and mature, spiritual and moral, and a lifelong learner. This year's Crespi Man is Quinn Muldoon. Vice Principal of Student and Campus Development, and Mrs. Sharon Barkins-Watson, the Director of Counseling, will be assisting Dr. Shield and Father Tom as we now begin the presentation of diplomas to the class of 2014. Row 1, please stand. Thomas James Abagian. Nicholas Anthony Albanese. Brian Joseph Alex. John George Alex. Dylan Vladimir Alpha. Victor Vincent Alvarez. Christopher Ayu. Aria Azizi. Mehdi Joseph Bagchesara. Benjamin Michael Barth. Oliver J. Basir. Zachary James Beach. Alexander Paul Burkholz. Matthew Stephen Bernard. Christopher Clay Lakely. Warren G. Bonilla. Joseph Hector Bourbon. Row 1, please be seated. Row 2, please stand up.
Joseph Jackson Briscoe V. John Benjamin Brown. Christian Emmanuel Buendia. Jonathan Alexander Dule Boulogne. Gregory Ronald Burr. Maxwell Chase Byington. Joseph Quinn Campanella. Hausham Kevin Cow. Brian Robert Carter. Keenan John Casey. Trevor Tran Chain. Yeah! Armani Emmanuel Cook. Cheyenne Hormaz Dalal. Nicholas Paul DeBecky. Austin Dean DeCosta. Jacob Michael Deering. Justin Chandler Dane. Row 2, please take your seats. Row 3, please stand up. Jose Sale Dizon. Valera Amador Jabur. Jonah Lee Dotan. Carl Joseph Eisenrath. Manon Engels. Adam James Fusilier. Angelico Paulo A. Garcia. Gino Rosario Gasparo. Billy Yee. Jason Russell Jensarowski. Montana Gerard Giffen. Eric John Blody. Garrett McGilvery Gordon. Caleb Martin Gossett. Lefebvre Joseph Gucci's III. Jonathan Vidal Guerrero. Row 3, please be seated. Row 4, please stand up. Eric James Hahn. Arthur Adam Hanusen. Colin Daniel Hughes. James Jakes. Armette Johnson. Quentin Xavier Johnson. Salvador Odilo Johnson. Gunnar Frederick Yulsen. Juan Kim. Dylan Rice Clump. Joseph Robert Kokenda Law. William Alejandro Lopez. Noah Skyler Mark. Chase Austin Martin. Anthony Philip Martinez. Row 4, please be seated. Row 5, please stand up. Zachary Roe Mauser. John Patrick Mayer. Cooper James McCary. Casey Andrew McGinnis. Connor Austin McMahon. Timothy Maged Bakari. Nicholas David Maynard. Ryan Howard Miller. Elmer Wagadir Molina. Alex Daniel Montilla Gudo. Andre Stephen Morales. Sebastian Avon Morales. Devin Patrick Morris. Matthew Cameron Motamity. Quinn James Muldoon. Trevor Leslie Mile. Row 5, please be seated. Row 6, please stand up. Ryan Christopher Nassau. John Uri Nichols. Karush Harder Nowry. Daniel Fernando Olivo Sandoval. Yeah. Eduardo Paredes. Tristan Parkinson. Amir Ali Fakir Patterson. Aaron Antonio Paz. Anthony Paul Perez. Brandon Jeffrey Pillar. Graham Anthony Olichek. Max Eduardo Portillo. Christian Carlos Prudencio. Theodore Sean Ragsack. Joseph Anthony Reyes. Row 6, please be seated. Row 7, please come up. Joshua Romero. Jack Aaron Romine. Keon Samini. Gavin Thomas Samples. Hayden Thomas Sands. John Lewis Starr. Matthew Edward Schoenzack. Joseph Nicholas Schwartz. Bennett Matthias Schaefer. Jordan Vance Silvers. George Cillion. Blair Ryan Simpkins. Jason Slayman. Vance Matthew Dinulos Solanap. Abithamarok Kelvin Sombali. Matthew Edwin Sulamayotis. Charles Remington Steele. Row 7, please be seated. Row 8, please come up. Anton A. Suharez. Lucas M. Sermian. Connor Ray Danny. Daryl J. Ursley. Douglas Leroy Van Cleve. Peter Luke Van Hall. Michael Yancey Vasquez. Jacob Thomas Viella. Shay von Hetzendorf. Thomas Stephen Wall. Adrian James Borland. Julian Ramsey Warren. Nathan Michael Washington. Jonathan Scott Wildwater. Jeffrey Franklin Welk. Thomas Owen Yeager Jr. Joseph David Gingers. Row 8, please be seated. Dr. Shield, the principal of Crespi Carmelite High School, will now address the graduates with some closing remarks.
It is a privilege to stand here for Fall Out here today, to look out and see so many faces who belong to the Crespi family. On behalf of Board Chairman Canavo, members of the board, Father Tom, Father Dustin of Carmelites, faculty, alumni, family and friends, I am honored to present the graduating class of 2014. May Our Lady of Mount Carmel continue to bless you all. Congratulations and welcome to the Alumni Association.